So already I make a host. Okay, correct. Let we shall start. Om Namah Shivaya Gurave Sachidananda Murtaye Nisprapanchaya Santaya Niralambaya Tejase Om Gangurubhyo Namaha Om Ganganapataye Namaha Om Ayam Sarasataye Namaha Om Klim Kalikaya Namaha Om Klim Bhadrakali Namaha Om Gam Durgaya Namaha Om Him Namah Shiva Sankaram Sankaracharyam Kesavam Vadarayanam Sutrahasakratam Vande Bhagavanto Punaha Punaha Eswara Gururatmete Murti Veda Vibhagini Vyamavada Vaptadehaya Tridachinamurtaye Namaha Tridachinamurtaye Namaha Tridachinamurtaye Namaha. So, you are very welcome. Today is a live satsang. Live satsang from the Kamakhya temple is behind. Just here, if I sit down here and watch my balcony, I can see the temple. It's just a 50 meter only. So I'm the border of the entrance is my door also. I can go inside it and the temple Kamakhya. So today is a special day and auspicious day. And today called Panchami, Sri Panchami. And today also I had special darshan and morning time around 10 o'clock, 10:30, and that in the Guhya Dwara, where the sacred, the mother is a life, mother is a residence living. So that is very nice, beautiful to see that, and very much built by the ancient architect. Is the temple is built by the architect of the Vedic and Tantric concept, both. It's called Dakshinacharya, Kaulacharya, Bhamacharya as well. Is because all kind of worship inside the temple is all Vedic and Tantric science. Inside temple, no tamasic and pure sattvic and pure sattva. But outside, the sacrifice area is a lot of tamas. Rasic qualities, because it's the violent and one sacrifice everything. So, but it is ancient traditions and it is the part of rituals. And here, and you must know that, and and this is all our, you can understand a little bit, the temple built by, according to architect of Sri Vidya, Sri Vidya, Sri Yantra. You understand me, all people? Can you hear me? Yes?
Yeah, hear very good.
Yes, very good. I also hear you today. So this is very special. And the people are here. Generally, it was overseen by the priest. But the priest, naturally, I had some kind of interact with the priest and the special priest of the Kamakhya temples. And they can also drink alcohol. And they can eat also meat, the sacrificed animals. And so their lifestyle, like, is a household life. So like the five things are a conjunction there, like Panchamakar, what to study as a house life. But inside temple, there is no Panchamakar at all, to mother to worship. No. They have everything worship outside. In the so main temple, and it was pure sattva, pure sattva. And is more transcendental. Today I had a special experience, and with the priest when I enter into, it was my whole body was like, you know, trembling, like it's like magnet, and my whole body like shaking. I was fully aware, I fully standing, and it was a kind of full power, full of awakening. Not happening with me many temples, but this is very special, and very special. Even the time I took sannyas, when a guru is giving, when a guru is giving me, so my guru Swami Dhyananandji, when he giving me sannyas, my whole body was trembling also. My whole body was like a, like how say, shaking. So it's feeling like something happening. So, and that my darshan, rested was a miracle, and I was arriving late evening. And everybody said we can't actually have darshan. But what happening? So I scared a little bit, something like that. Then I tried to walk with around one Swami, and from the Akhada mother place. He said, let me shall walk. I said, I walk. So I won't take on photos like that. But fortunately, they said temple is closed completely. We can't visit. But I tried to enter in. The door was open. One day, because the priest, they want to coming out of the temple. It was around 6:35. And just 2 minutes. And 2 minutes, I just visit them. And I visit the mother. They said, no, you can't visit. So it means the mother actually waiting for me long time. Because I have planned for last 25 years. And to come to visit the mother Kamakhi. Mother, only one place, the Unipetam. You must know that. And this Unipetam is not, you don't take as a form of like Kali. No. This Unipetam is the personification of a virgin. Virgin goddess. So this is a Kamakhya is a virgin. Bala. We say Vala. Vala means the virgin goddess. Like Vairava. And here they have also, it was time, and you know, there was story, a Bhairav, you know, and many sadhakas, many yogis, they actually have their tapasya, their sadhana. So what happened? And mother, she appeared, and then Bhairava, Bhairav means as a yogi, as a human form. And he said that, I want to marry you. Then, mother say, you are calling me mother, how is possible that? No, you are so beautiful, I want to marry you. Say, I am a, so one thing you do. And, but that time the Bhairav, he did not notice that. She's a mother. And mother Kamakhi itself. He say, one thing you do. He just built the many stairs in the temple, in this mountain. You make the stairs like 100 meter or 200 meters like that. And you make the stairs, and once you completed the stairs, then I can marry you. So what happening? Actually, mother and left him, this sadhaka yogi, the Vairava, like Kapalik, whatever. The story like that. Just a Vairava. And he tried to make the stairs. He never finished the stairs. He left his body. So in this way, mother could not marry. So what I mean, there is some kind of a stories. There are some stairs in the mountains. I did not went to saw that. They went there, the Vala Bhairavi. Vala Bhairavi. Vala means, in Russian language, they call Vala means little, young, little, Vala, right? I think Marianne, she can understand Vala.
Vala. I think that Sanskrit.
Sanskrit, but also in Russian language, they use called Vala. Vala means small, little, and virgin. So Vala Bhairavi, I never heard the Vala Bhairavi. In Kamakhya, in Kamakhi temple in Tamil Nadu, they say called Vala, Vala Sundari, little, beautiful mother. So what I mean here, and this place, Kamakhya, and very beginning when I come, so my, I did not feel so comfortable because outside a lot of sacrifice, lot of sacrifice. Lot of animals still there. The goat, you know, they actually sacrifice like, I did not see the chickens, they sacrifice swan, like the pigeons and the black goat, you understand? And they, and I heard somebody say that they also sacrifice buffalo as well. And, but there are some story, they think they're sacrifice also human being in ancient time, in old age. Like Adiguru Shankaracharya came here, as a story, and the Bhairava want to sacrifice the head of Adiguru Shankaracharya. But of course, and you know this story. And then Adiguru Shankaracharya and his disciple came and he chopped the head of Bhairava, the Kapalika as well. Then, so these are stories. But how much truth? So Mother no, Lord Shiva no, Parasakti no, Mother Kamaki story behind it. So what I mean here, so Kamakhi, you say Kamakhya, no, Kamakhya temple here, and very auspicious place, and one of the Siddha place, because it's the only Yonipetam, and there's this temple, and it was built by architect by the Srividya. Whole temple is Srividya, not Srividya established exactly inside. And there is a huge, when you go inside, so how it is, there is no statue. Kamakhya is not a statue. It's a huge stone. You must understand. As a form of a yoni, and the, where the water coming. And water comes. So that water this, so second time I get it. So it was for me, I mean, I have no words to express. I have not so much words to express. And to visit here, to have darshan of Mata Kamakhi, Kamakhya temple Mataji, to visit here, to have darshan, it takes me so many years. And I heard about this temple, about Mother, so many years, maybe more than 25 years already. And always I have some kind of plan and to visit here. But even this year, I have some plan with the CEO Puja to come here. But doesn't it work? It doesn't it work. And so I have all the time, many plans like previously. All the time, cancel. I say, when Mother will invite me, then I'll come. So it was happen. And I left this time in Rishikesh and went to the, all the way to the Bihar. And there I revised my all the Kriya Yogas, all Kriya Yoga in the Babaji. Not exactly Babaji, the Lahari Master tradition, because many people call Babaji now. And many fake Kriya Yogis also as well, fake. That is not actually true. People take the real Babaji Kriyas. People can teach whatever they want, but one should not give the name of Babaji. Like, for example, Bihar School of Yoga, they never give the name of Babaji. Because my grandma Swami Satyam, he got the Kriya Yoga technique from Swami Sivanaji Maharaj with the, Saktipath. It is like transmissions. Because for Saktipath, he had to wait for a long time. Swami Satyananji Maharaj, and he had, so many seva, more than 10, 12 years. And then after that, his purification, he got the Saktipath. So this is also part of Kriya Yoga. And then, and my grandmaster, so whatever he taught, the Kriya Yoga is not the lineage of Babaji, of his own realizations, of his own enlightenments, that what he got blessings and grace of Swami Sivananda. So that is the Bihar School of Yoga. But I have been studying something academically, but same time, and also we teach academical lot of things. But it's very important to have the initiation Dikhya. Dikhyas are very important. In Babaji tradition, Lahadi Mahasaya, and first the Dikhya, they first explain Swadhaya. Tapa Swadha Isar Pranidhanani Iti Kriya Yoga. So this is the studs. So in Lahadi Mahasaya, they try to also teach Gita, even the Sankhya philosophy, Purusha and Prakriti, and then like Patanjali Yoga Sutra as well. So they have a lot of quotations. You have to study what is tapa, what is the swadhaya, and what is the Ishwara Pranidhan. What is the Ishwara Pranidhan? So these are all are the. So it depends how you go to understand from the master to master, acharya to another acharya. So I feel very fortunate, and what I took initiation long time before, in 2001. So it was for me opportunity and to have revised all the techniques, and certain things are also there is some kind of practice, physical practice as well. So that is not the kriyas, but you need to have a good body, the smooth body, to practice kriya yoga. So kriya yoga is all about to prepare yourself and to meditations. So kriya yoga all about to the leads to the meditations. And in future, and when you meet me physically, so once again I'll also initiate the secrets of the Babaji and Lahari Maya's kriyas as well. And I initiate many people in previously, but I would like to people get the proper and authentic techniques. Authentic techniques. But same time, and nothing wrong, the, you know, people study our Kundalini Tantra book and written by our grandmaster. So also they written, you can practice with you under guidance of acharyas of that school for at least for 3 months or whatever. You know that, huh? You know all the instructions. So everybody free to do whatever they wanted. But academical study is kind of also preparations. Like people study a little bit asanas, and once they're training some asanas, they also follow some books and study asanas as well. But the Kriya Yoga is very important techniques because that is coming from science of, science of Tantra as well. So what I mean, and for Kriya Yoga, we need blessings, the grace. To get the Kriya Yoga, Diksha, the initiation, and you must continue with the same masters. You're supposed not to confuse, understand? If you're confused, what happening? If you're doubts and confused, not trust that master, what happening? It also leads you, if you get the Kriya Yoga initiation from other masters, it also brings confusion and doubts as well. You understand me? Because confusion leads to the confusion. Doubts lead to doubts. Even one Kriya is like Narad giving to the Valmiki Rishi. You chant Ram. This is your Kriya. This is also Kriya. It's like Satyapath. Like Satyapath. Like Swami Sivananda giving in a few minutes, like 1-2 minutes. It's called transmission. That is how our Grandmaster Swami Satyananda was received the Kriya Yoga initiations. And like in Chidbilasanam, in Mukta, near Pune, you know, Siddhashram. Also, they're giving the transmission, Satyapath. So what I mean is very important. And once you got the initiation from the master, you keep continue the trusting that and stability. Otherwise, it's very difficult. The life will be and trouble. So you understand what I mean to you, all of you? Because spiritual science is very important. How much you trust yourself, and then that how much you trust the master. So it's very important. And if you do, the spirituality and spiritual science is long time to trust, not today, not tomorrow. So very beginning, and it's not possible. Very beginning is not possible, and to understand. Very beginning, I'm in the class now. Who is here? Just for a moment.
I have class now. I'm studying.
So I'm sorry. There are some people come here. The priest who taking care of me, because he wants to do special puja, the Kumari puja, the Virgin Goddess puja. So it is a like life puja. So because it costs money, so I say, let me to think, because I do always Kumari puja, Virgin. So in the inside temple, there will be Virgin, a girl coming to sit down there, and there is kind of rituals to be done. So this kind of rituals, not many sannyasins do it, or many yogis do it. Generally, many householders people do it. But I told him, let me see what we can do. But because it cost around 100 euros, you know, almost like that. So I said to him, let me to think about the finance situations, and then we can proceed the pujas. It's like rituals, because here they have their beliefs, and you coming to Kamasya, it is a virgin goddess, and you must do the virgin puja, the Kumari puja, you know. Kumari puja means a little girl coming, more than 5 years, or below 12 years, to worship their feet, you know, the water, the giving very nice, the dress, and giving sweets and so on. It is kind of rituals in tantri perspectives also. But anyway, I do also in our ashram. So I need to think. And today also I did a special puja, special darshan about the, I'll say special ticket to go in. So it is like that. So what is the subject now about this kriyas, right? The topic was kriyas. So kriyas actually,
topic is kamakya.
Topic is kamakya, right? So topic is kamakya. So kamakya in the temple, you can see that is also as well. So it is the kamakya. So it is many kind of kriyas. For example, as I say that today, to explain you how they do external worships, panchamakardiya. And therefore, priests generally, they're householders. So they can do 5 things. They can eat meat and fish and mudras and maithuna and alcohol, madhya as well. And they do perform because they're Brahmins. And so they can do that. But that is does not applicable for the sannyasins. Do you understand me? Like yogis, for example, are different. So they are for inside temple, and there is nothing panchamakars, because they are panchamakar, they worship different. And when do also Kumari puja, and they are also sacrifice. And I told to the priest, offer you sacrifice any animals. No, I told him we have to do Vedic sacrifice. We can break the coconut, or we can have special kind of kusmat, special kind of fruits. So I can chop them and sacrifice. That what I do in our ashram. Sacrifice the like coconut and putting the red colors or the special kind of fruits also we can chop. Like sacrifice to the mother. But they're offering all animals to sacrifice the blood. So that's the difference. I say no, I want to do puja here and rituals. So I can request to the mother, I want sattvic pujas, not the tamasic pujas. Although I don't know, because these are traditions are here. So I told him, let we shall do the Vedic Dakshinacharya, also Kolacharya, Bhamacharya, you can do also, but in different way. Like I explained already, the secrets of yoga, Gupta sadhana, Gupta tantric sadhana. Already I explained you how you can really offer the like a panchamakar, the mansa, masya, madhya, maithuna, and mudras. I already explained you in sattvic form, not in the tamasic form. Although there is a tamasic way to do puja, rajasic way to do puja, and sattvic forms. So three kind of a way you can actually do rituals. But somehow, so being here in Kamakya, you are so blessed. If you are here, and I feel very blessed myself. Of the Sri Vidya, we do so 1,000 years. We not get blessings. We not get the grace. Sri Vidya, Tripura Sundari. And here, the temple itself, Sri Vidya. And Tripura Sundari. And we do so much work, so hard work, so hard job to get the perfections. But Kamakya temple itself, when you come here, get blessings. But of course, many people are also here. Doesn't mean everybody get the blessings. But somehow, when you are here and come with your devotion, come with love, self-surrender, Ishwar Pranidhan, that is very important. Ishwar Pranidhan here, actually, Ishwar means an immortal, something is immortal. And Pranidhan means to offer, actually. Pranidhan means offer, to surrender. So here, and then another way, to surrender to what? To immortality. To keep continuity. That is the special way. Pranidhan. Then another way they say, what is pranidhan? They say dhyana means meditation. And one has to do meditation. So pranidhan means, real pranidhan is the completely awareness of yourself. When it says self surrender is your pranidhan, actually not. A person has to aware itself. Awareness of itself. So, and that is the Ishwara Pranidhan. And so this, what I try to explain you, so Kamakhya, Ma, Kamakhya Ma, and itself has the special energy and special prana. So you can say, see the Parasakti. But without her grace, what I experienced here since long time, so without grace of a mother here, actually you can't reach. You can't arrive here. And sometimes you can arrive, you can have proper darshan also. So therefore, and my grandmaster Swami Satyananji Maharaj, he used to do a lot of tapasya here in Kamakhya. Secret. He did his own, and he's a great master of Tantra Sastras, and he did a lot of secret practice here. And today also, and when I was meditating, and when I was doing sadhana evening, almost around 5 o'clock, and after that, only 7:30, 7:35 p.m., I was constantly sitting where the sacrifice animals, because many people go there and sit down. What happening when I don't know what the scientific reasons, but when I went there, very beginning, like yesterday, I went, my whole body was traveling. I was not feeling good at all. I was feel very fear and afraid, very much fear, very much afraid. And today I was trying to sit down there, and there are a group of people coming, and another state from Tripura. They're all a devotee of Sivas, and also I'll sending the photographs. They are all sitting my left side, and I was alone. And somebody make me a little bit fear. Don't go there. If you have late night, something happen, maybe you never know. Maybe they will sacrifice you as well. Like this, somebody told me. I says, fine, doesn't matter that. So anyway, so I was spending today and evening all the way. And so evening time, there are not people many. So we are more easier to have darshan and all these things. But I was trying to and meditate. I did my all sadhana, all my sadhana, all the, because I have some kind of tantric sadhana. So I did my tantric sadhana there, and siddhant is very open. And I have my japam and sitting in meditation, whatever. Then I pray and for all people, let the destroy the asuras, let the establish the dharma. So that is my main prayers today. And you understand me? Establish the dharma, let the destroy the all asuras. If asuras are not destroyed, they'll misguide to the world also. So now Atman, we can understand, is smiling. As special prayer today, let asura has to be destroyed. I don't want people are fake. People are fake. And their name of dharma, they actually misguide many people in the world. And that the asuras, they do always. Asuras, they always do. And they have to be destroyed. So, and that the special prayers. And one day I can speak with Atman very openly. So let's see. So what happening? So let the dharma has to be established. Adharma has to be destroyed. And then the Lord Shiva. So today I was sitting there, and I have kind of a vision. I feel like my grandmaster there, his spirit. You understand? Because maybe I'm a celebrity psychic, or maybe I have some mental problems. Or I was sit down, I can feel my grandmaster is like moving or like talking, because I can see his face. He was very kind to me. Swami Satyananda Maharaj, my grandmaster, he always kind. I just tell one story to all of you. It was the time I went to the Rikhiya, and where my grandmaster spent his last life. He left his body in Rikhiya. So it was the time I did not get permission to stay in Rikhiya residential, because then I stayed in the hotel. Then one day I came there, I wrote the letter to the institution, to Swami Satyananji, like this, very nicely in English. And it was helped my one of my guru brother, his name also Swami Samarpanam. He said that you write down like this. We both wrote the letter, but they did not call him, they called me. So then I went, and he, Swami Satyananda is my grandmaster. He called to his the disciple Swami Satsangiji. Then he instructed to her, give the place to Mahatma coming from Rishikesh. And I remember today very clearly. And she said, no, there is no place. There is no place. Swami Satsangiji said, no place in the ashram. Then what happened? My grandmaster said, you know, no problem. If there is no place, let him to sleep on the floor. Let put something on the floor and give the place him with the senior Swamiji. Yeah, all senior Swamis, they live in the building. Let him to, he don't need bed. He can sleep in the floor. He's a Mahatma coming from Rishikesh. So that he was the, you can imagine that the love, the compassion of my grandmaster. And he let me, then I tell him, where are you staying? I say, that time I say Paramahansa, because people say like Paramahansa or Sri Swamiji. I say, Paramahansa, I don't know. Currently here is no place, therefore I stay in hotel. And you think a Mahatma has to stay in a hotel or to stay in his guru place? No. You just come here. Then you can imagine that Swami Satsangaji cannot, because Swami Satsangaji sometimes he says something, then my grandmaster also accepting. But that day, my grandmaster does not accept her. No. You need to give the place to him. He need to sleep in the floor with his senior Swamiji. And I got the place. And that is my grandmaster, Swami Satyananda. Even my guru sometimes, my guru has no power also there in his Rikhya. He could not say nothing. He was neutral. But I did not ask him anyway for the play, for the accommodation. I never asked him. Because I know that is not a place of my guru. Because the place of guru is the Munger. So then I did not ask him. When Swami Niranjan come to Rikhya, he's like a guest. He's free. He's like Olek Niranjan. He is very happy and very relaxed because his master is his own masterpiece. So therefore, and that day, so what I mean, my grandmaster have so much grace for me. And I am not so famous in Bihar School of Yoga. I'm not very much obedient disciple from the Bihar School of Yoga. Or I'm nowhere actually. I have nothing to do with it there. And I'm normally most of the time staying in Rishikesh and traveling like that. But one way, and whenever I go to my Guruji, so there I'm always humble to them. So what I mean to you here, so my grandmaster was so humble, so my grandmaster has so much blessings for me. He has so much grace. I give another story of miracle. That is how I feel today, temple and meditate. But therefore I have already planned to go to the Rikhya and to visit the Samadhi place. Then I go to the Munger. Either they're accepting or not accepting. Whatever the happening, I don't know. Let me surrender. I'm not going to calling them. I simply go there. Otherwise, I do namaskar out of the gate and getting out. That is my plan. Either not allow me. So that is my plans. So what happening another day? Same thing with the miracle of my another. Same thing, Grandmaster, what happened? Very interesting story. Very interesting. And it was a time because everybody said to me, no, you must stay in the Bihar School. You must stay in the Bihar School of Yoga. So what happened? I asked the Swami Satyananda in 97. I remember that. And I told him, do you think I supposed to stay in Bihar School of Yoga or Rishikesh? What do you think? No, you stay in Rishikesh. That is my master place. You stay there, not here. That is your training place now. So that is the word of my grandmaster. It was another incident. The third incident with my grandmaster, everything happening miraculously with my grandmaster, who is most of the time, I think he don't know me, nothing. Only Swami Niranjan, my gurus, he maybe know, or Swami Satsang, because I'm very, you know, physically talk with them. But generally with my grandmaster, never I speak any personal or physically anything. So another time it was happened, I was sitting very much behind. A lot of people sitting, you know, because there are many senior Swamis, many VIP. So I'm neither senior Swami, I'm nor VIP. You know, I'm kind of a like little idiot. So always, you understand me? Little idiot. So always I stand behind. I say, I'm nothing special. Because whenever I go to Bihar School of Yoga, I never think I'm special. I always think I'm just like an idiot. Because everybody stay there. They do a lot of, you know, they lot of seva. They're very much dedicated and all these things. but somehow I never want to be very famous there also. No. So near Guru, I always keep up simple. So I was sitting the behind. So what happened that day? I remember today, and my grandmaster sitting in the chair a long way, maybe 25 meters or 20 meters, like this. A lot of people are behind it. And I was sitting completely behind. You know what happening? He just called me, himself, he called me. Hey, who is this? Because I was putting orange cloth. Let this Mahatma come to front side. I said, what happening? There is a lot of people sitting in nice dress, not Mahatma, like, you know, like many foreigners, many Indians, and who have big money or I don't know, donation or big devotees. So I was neither big devotees, neither good sannyasin, and nothing I am. So then he called me. He said, you come to front side. I was so surprised. And after that, come front side. Then what happened? And he gave me some duty. Just go to their yagya mandap. Around, just there, you sit down there. Just look after it. And I was standing, I was going there. And it was also appointed by also around the yagya mandap someone. Then one day, that was called by the, you could imagine that? Swami Satyan called me from back to front side. And there is some VIP, they said, you say, if you are not VIP, go to back, let this Mahatma come to front side. I was so surprised. I was so surprised. This is another miracle for me, incident. Although that time, I don't think so, he know me. But he one day asked him, Guruji, I am Swami Samarpan, coming from Rishikesh. Do you know me? I know very well. This Swami Niranjan always talk about you. So I know it. I know you. So you don't think I don't know you. I know you very well. I shut up my mouth. One day I shut up. Somebody introduced me in Rishikesh. This is Swami Samarpanan. Oh, I know him. Swami Niranjan talk about him. So I know him. So let him finish. I always think my grandmaster never know me. But he always knew. That is how it is. So what I mean, so today I have such kind of, when I was meditating doing sadhana, so many things I feel like this one Satyam is here. You know, my grandmaster moving here and they had to protect me, not to sacrifice my head here. Yeah, because there are many animals sacrificed to mother, it doesn't matter. So they can sacrifice me as well. Like, so like Shankaracharya, but yet I'm not on the Brahmagyana way, but I'm the path of Brahmagyana. Yeah? When Brahmagyana happen, we'll know. We'll see that. So anyhow, when you know, you know. When you don't know, then that's different things. And then, so what I mean here to you, all of you, but you always can have the grace, grace of the masters, grace of the masters. So grace of masters comes how? We don't know. It's very important. Once you are really dedicate your own master, it's not physically to dedicate. It's very important. The consciousness, you understand me? Your attitude, your bhav has to dedicate, has to be positive and long sustainability. So most of the time, what we are doing in our life, being a disciple, we generally not possible to dedicate to our gurus. Not possible. But at least we can have positive. We can have positive. You know, why not possible to dedicate completely? Because you don't know what is guru. Because you don't, we don't focus that consciousness of guru within ourselves. We don't focus it. We don't know. So it's very difficult disciple to surrender. But more easier, guru can surrender to disciples. Because guru nobody is the disciple. Like the Lord Krishna, he was surrendered to Arjuna. But Arjuna was have some kind of doubts, a lot of confusions to be surrendered to Lord Krishna. Therefore, you can see, and if there is good master, like Lord Krishna, and he can really give good education, like Arjuna. But it's very important, the trust. But Lord Arjuna was fully trust, maybe not completely dedicated, but he has some doubts and confusions. So what I mean, being a disciple, very difficult for us to completely surrender. But the more you walk in depth level, the more you are walking inwards, the more you are traveling inwards, inner journey means the spiritual journey, the more you know the guru. The more you know the guru. Today, according to my state of the consciousness, 30 years back, my consciousness was different. Every moment I think about my guru. Every moment. today. You understand what I mean? So, even if sometimes some people said to me, Swamiji, Guruji, like me, Swami Samarpanji, you don't need actually the physical guru. Why you need this? You are so and establish yourself. I say, I don't have that ego. I don't have that. No, I am very humble. I need always the guru. So far, guru is the life physical. So what I mean, so most of the time we think logically, we are so smart and we go television, we go internet, we go, you know, we go all kind of books. But remember, you never can get input. You never can get feedback. No input. No input from books. No input from the, like you say, I'm Brahmasmi. What happened? It doesn't mean anything. I'm a Brahman. I'm a Shiva. It doesn't mean anything. It is intellectual information. So this is rubbish. It's nonsense. Nonsense completely. So what I mean? So whatever you study, whatever you're doing, it doesn't bring the feedback. So guru is very important. Either you walk any path. So, but it's very important, long sustainability. Long sustainability. What I mean, you understand me? You have to trust long time without personal desires, ambitions. Sometimes we can have other masters as well, other acharyas, but same time, don't forget your previous master, previous teachers, because they are your pillars. They are your foundation. You understand me? They are your foundations. They are your pillars. They are your pillars and foundations. That is very important to understand. Because they're giving the strength to walk. Like your mother and father, they give this physical body. Maybe today they're idiot. They cannot help you. But you must remember, they are your source of your physical body. So you must respect any and all conditions. Similarly, the teacher you once accept, maybe teaching asanas, doesn't matter, but still you must respect. Some teacher may be teaching ABCD, must respect, because that gives today whatever you achieve today. So we should not forget. But most of the time, according to European education, you reject everything and whatever comes now, and you simply respect that. So what I mean? So actually you lost the morals. You have all kind of education in civilized country in the Europe, but you lost the morals. And that moral education only exists in the spiritual science of India, only in the Vedic cultures. That no culture in the world, the moralities exist. So what I mean, morality is not for honestness. Morality is not truthful. Morality is something need to be constantly trust, constant trust without personal fulfillment. Without personal agenda and personal expectations. And that the real morals one can develop. The morals, very important. And you don't educate the morals, that means you can't walk the path, one step of the spiritual path that you study in Vivek Chudamani, right? Vivek Chudamani study, what is that? It's called Viveka. Viveka is very important to awaken. And most of the time, we really reject the Viveka, the morals. Then actually you are in trap. You are in trouble. So this must today, what I like to speak about this Kamakhya temple is the fully, the awakening place. Once you, and you must visit here in future and with love and with the positive attitude and with kind of no expectations. Of course, we have a lot of expectations. I have also so. But it's very important, let and samarpanam to the mother. Let samarpanam. Samarpanam means let the offer yourself. Let the mother decide. Whatever you have wishes, you can bring into the consciousness of mother. And mother knows what is the best for you. Mother knows what is best for you. That is very important. And that is what today I informed mother. These all are my wishes. And whatever you decide, So it's very important and to surrender. And mother knows. Mother maybe don't know everything about child, but mother knows many things about the child. And so therefore, whatever mother understood, give the child. But see, the divine mother is not a common mother. Not a common mother. See, the divine mother. See, beyond the mind, beyond the intellect, and beyond this material concept. So she knows. Mother knows what is the best for you. So in this concept, and Parasakti is everywhere. And Parasakti also here. But place also very important. Places are very important. Particular place, you can do proper sadhana. every place very difficult to sadhana because proper energy not there, proper waves not there, proper waves of the energy. So it's very important. And the place you do sadhana, the pranic energy has to be awakened. Pranic energy has to be awakened. So that place is more easier to meditate. Why go temple and particular cave? Because the energy is already there. So that prana is helping you to purifications and in order to also do sadhana and for the achievement of the meaning of the life. So therefore, and Kamakhya place, one of them and good place for sadhana. But you have to come with the positive attitude as well. Because yesterday I didn't feel good. Today at morning time, I say, oh, should I go to temple or not? It kind of like that. Yesterday I feel so good. Then because lived the sacrifice, the animals. And therefore I try to contemplate today, to observe myself. Because so many spirits are there, so many spirits, because they sacrifice the animals. It is kind of, for me, according to another concept, is kind of liberating the animal consciousness. So they can born as a human form, more spontaneously. Any animals are sacrificed here, they can born as human being, as per some kind of understanding I have. Understand me? So this I can pray here and to the mother, and please liberate these animals and let them to be human being and come to worship you. Let them to liberate. Let them to be free. So this much now, because today the mobile battery going to die, and I didn't bring my reserve battery here. I forgot. So I tried to now recharge. So thank you. And if you have any 1-2 questions, let me clear. Any questions?
Explain Shisha. Shisha place, said this place for Shisha, disciples. You understand me?
Shisha.
Shisha, Shisha, yeah.
Shisha, Shisha means a disciple. Shisha, the female disciple. Shisha, the male disciple. Shisha and Shisha, Chela and Cheli. These are not students. Student, we say in Hindi, Chhatra, Chhatri, student. And a disciple and Shisha and Shisha is very much Sanskrit, is a more spiritual words. One says Shisha and Shisha. Shisha means a male disciple. Shisha means female disciple. Those who have clinging to enlightenment, they are sick to the enlightenment. And Shisha means here, Shisha means the complete dedication and constant study with the master until unless enlightenment, until all the way to enlightenment. This life, next life, another life. But due to our personal desires, personal expectations, wishes, sometimes we leave the guru and we say they're called Bhastra Yogi. So generally, they're in the traps and they lost this path so they can and come next life or after 7 lives. And especially our Vedic science, once you are initiated, and even this life, you, due to your some personal desires, you not connect with that guru, but you have to come to next life or another life or another life, and that is no doubts. This is the because this is the culture of intuitive knowledge. It's not intellectual knowledge. It's not intellectual. It's not academic educations. So our Vedic science, the science of Brahma Vidya, the Vedic parampara, the science of revelations. Science of intuitions is guru disciple traditions. So that you have to be very clear. So thank you. And I try to conclude. Om Namasevaya Gurave Sachidananda Murtaye Nisprapanchaya santaya niralambaya tejase sankaram sankaracharyam kesavam badarayanam sutrabhaschakritam vande bhagavanto punaha punaha iswara guratmeti muti veda vibhagine vyamavad vyapta dehaya Siddhachina Murtaye Namaha Om Gungurubhyo Namaha. So, Kamaki Mayaki Jai. कामाख्या मैया की जय, बोले भोले बाबा की जय, महामाई की जय, महाकाली की जय, त्रिपुरा सुंदरी महामाई की जय, बोलो नमः पार्वती वदे हर हर महादेव। लोका समस्ता सुखिनो भवन्तु, लोका समस्ता सुखिनो भवन्तु, लोका समस्ता सुखिनो भवन्तु। ओम शांति शांति शांति। ओम ओम नमः शिवाय।